still gotta walk into a crowded room with a radio on. Crack a smile and crack a beer like it don't bother you, like it ain't your song that's on. Still gotta cross the bridge to get to work, the one by her place. Make it through the 9 to 5 like it don't hurt. It goes that way when someone stops loving you. It don't make the evening news. It don't keep the summer rising, clock from winding, your heart from beating. Someone starts loving you. Still gotta button up your collared shirt, the one she used to button down. Sleep on the mattress where her body left a curve. Maybe just the couch. Still gotta keep a number in your phone in case she calls back one night when she's drunk and all alone. Yeah, you pray for that. When someone stops loving you, it don't make.
Your hand down into the cool. drink it if the mountains are blue. Try to keep it steady as you recline on your black inner tube. Pontoon, making waves and catching rays up on the roof. Jumping on the back.
Bone dogs. selfish hole. Five cop poker on.
My understanding is we're supposed to have a national anthem. So I'm hoping we're going to play the national anthem. You don't want me to sing, no. We could have all of you sing. Maybe we could do it together. Have a seat. We appreciate it. So for those of you who were worried about the 90 degree temperatures, isn't this beautiful? Let's see if we can get through it without a storm, okay? So hello and welcome, CPI faculty, staff, administration, parents, friends, and most importantly, our 2022 Central Pennsylvania Institute of Science and Technology certificate recipients. My name is Brian Griffith, and I'm superintendent here at Penns Valley Area School District, and we happen to be one of the three sending school districts that operate CPI for our students. On behalf of Mrs. Tammy Burniford, superintendent at Bellefonte Area School District, and Dr. Joe Clapper, interim superintendent at Bald Eagle Area School District, we all extend our most sincere welcome to mark this milestone event. This event is occurring for the second time physically at one of our partnered school districts. Although the original purpose of holding this event was motivated by the global pandemic, we now have established a new tradition and plan to hold these events on a rotating basis at our school district venues going forward. We believe this action demonstrates our district's commitment to our students and the quality programming that is offered at CPI. Our three school districts are extremely proud of the tradition of excellence that is CPI. Our school districts value career and technical education because it provides our students with the opportunity for a successful future. By attending CPI, each student has had the unique chance to participate in real life experiences, which are so important to being successful employees, business leaders, and post-secondary students. My sincere hope is that each student apply these skills in the next step that life has set before them. Again, we welcome each of you to Penns Valley and offer our sincere congratulations to our CPI certificate recipients on a job well done. Congratulations. It's now my pleasure to welcome to the podium Mrs. Kim Weaver, who is the president of the Joint Operating Committee.
Good evening. On behalf of the Joint Operating Committee, I would like to congratulate the class of 2022. 3 or 4 years ago, you made the decision to come to CPI. When you chose this path, you became part of an amazing family. You are not just an Eagle, a Raider, or a Ram. You are a proud graduate of the Central Pennsylvania Institute of Science and Technology. During those 3 or 4 years, CPI has inspired you to work together with students from other schools. CPI has engaged your skills with carpentry, landscaping, operating machinery, culinary techniques, lesson planning, dental working, computer skills, and many, many more. CPI has inspired you to become leaders through the skills program. CPI built friendships with students and staff that will last well into the future. CPI motivated you to step out of your comfort zone and try new things. Class of 2022, look around you. You are our future. I will give you one final thought from one of my favorite authors, Theodore Geisel, famously known as Dr. Seuss. Whether you color the world or light it up blue, you are making a difference, so keep being you. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Richard Makin, President, and Mrs. Marianne Volders, Vice President of Secondary Education, for the Special Recognition Awards.
Good evening. It is with excitement and pleasure that we come together this evening to recognize the accomplishments of the 144 seniors in the CPI class of 2022. The young men and women that we are celebrating tonight have demonstrated determination, dedication, and hard work in their endeavor to gain the technical skills and knowledge necessary for future success. As you look at your future, I want you to think about the positive impact that you can have on others and the communities in which you live. Whether your path will take you to the military, college, a technical school, or into the workplace, you will make a difference. Be passionate about everything that you do and strive to do your best every day so that your lives are filled with joy and pride. We are counting on you to make the world a better place. Thousands of dollars worth of scholarships, awards, and gifts were provided by local businesses, organizations, and contributors and will be given out this evening. I would like to thank the award sponsors for their generous contributions and support of our programs. Their names are listed in your program. At this time, I would like to make a few additional introductions. I want to welcome Mr. Mike Fedison, Vice Principal at Bellefonte, Mrs. Becky Michaels, Vice Principal at Bellefonte, Mr. Zach Weinkoop, Principal at Penns Valley, and Mr. John Tobias, Principal at Bald Eagle. Each year, many of our senior students are accepted into the National Technical Honor Society. This is the highest award for excellence in career and technical education. To be considered for the National Technical Honor Society, a student must be nominated by their instructor, maintain a 3.0 grade point average at CPI and their home school, have excellent attendance, and perform the required hours of community service. This year, we have 49 seniors that have met the requirements for acceptance into the National Technical Honor Society. In my 14 years at CPI, this is the most students that we've had as members of NTHS. This is a testament to their hard work and dedication at CPI and their home school. Please come forward when I call your name and make a line on the side of the stage so that your parents can give you your applause. Maya Barton, Early Childhood Education. Caitlin Bechtel, Medical Science Technology. Harley Benner, Horticulture and Landscaping. Abigail Billett, Early Childhood Education. Emma Bird, Early Childhood Education. Logan Blair, Information Technology Cisco. Cheyenne Butts, Horticulture and Landscaping. Sabrina Corman, Early Childhood Education. Colton Dietrich, Information Technology Cisco. Rachel Drabelbus, Cosmetology. Micah Federoff, Carpentry. Noah Federoff, Diesel Repair Technology. Tenley Gates, Cosmetology. Braden Greenaway, Diesel Repair Technology. Tiffany Grebe, Culinary Arts. James Geiser, Information Technology Cisco. Jalen Hahn, Emergency Services. Dylan Hartley, Cosmetology. Anna Hegedus, Emergency Services. Kylie Hockenberry, Early Childhood Education. Mackenzie Hockenberry, Horticulture and Landscaping. John Holzerman, Information Technology Cisco. Olivia Horner, Medical Science Technology. Madison Jackson, Early Childhood Education. Jordan Kleinfelder, Horticulture and Landscaping. Thomas Corman, HVAC. Gavin Kuhn, Carpentry. Justine Leiter, Medical Science Technology. Cameron Martin, Medical Science Technology. JC Masden, Cosmetology. Andrew McChesney, Emergency Services. Samantha Miller, Early Childhood Education. Austin Moore, Information Technology Cisco. Abby Palmer, Cosmetology. Caitlin Park, Medical Science Technology. Ashton Phillips, Information Technology Cisco, Michaela Ripka, Emergency Services, Joseph Shawley, Welding, Paige Shivery, Medical Science Technology, Lindsay Smiles, Medical Science Technology, Elizabeth Spiker, Emergency Services, Nolan Stover, Precision Machine Technology, Haley Watson, Medical Science Technology, Taylor Wetzel, Medical Science Technology, Gage Whitehill, Diesel Repair Technology, Timothy Wingert, Collision Repair Technology, Chastity Woods, Early Childhood Education, Max Yetzko, Information Technology Cisco, and last but certainly not least, Rayleigh Ziegler, Medical Science Technology. Let's give them a round of applause. I would also like Mrs. Gearhart to please stand up. Mrs. Gearhart is our NTHS advisor, and she does a wonderful job with this group of wonderful individuals. Thank you all. You may return to your seats. At this time, I'm going to ask Dr. Macon to help me present several special recognition awards. I will ask each of our award winners to come forward when your name is called. Students will not receive certificates or plaques on the stage unless it's the outstanding student certificate plaque. They can get everything in the back by the ticket booth on the way out. The first of our special recognition awards this evening is the E. Dell Simpson Memorial Award. Mr. Simpson was the Cooperative Education and Adult Education Coordinator at CPI for many years. This $100 award was established in Mr. Simpson's memory and is given to a student who plans on pursuing a post-secondary education. The 2022 E. Dell Simpson Memorial Award winner is a medical science student from Bald Eagle, Rayleigh Ziegler. Come on up, Rayleigh. We're going to make you all walk the whole way up here so you can shake our hands, but we're not going to give you your plaque until later. Another round of applause for Rayleigh, please. Our next two awards are the Kiwanis Club of Bellefonte Awards, and they're given to two students who have exhibited a strong work ethic, a spirit of cooperation, and a sincere desire to excel in their program area. These $100 awards go to Noah Fedoroff, who is a diesel repair student from Penns Valley, and Abby Palmer, who is a cosmetology student from Bald Eagle. Please come forward. Another round of applause for Noah. Wait, Noah, you gotta stop. You gotta wait for Abby. Another round of applause for Noah and Abby. Thank you. Our next two special awards, and by the way, we have 25 of them to give out here at the beginning. Our next two special awards are our local teachers union scholarships. The local teachers union is awarding two $100 scholarships to students that maintain high standards of personal and professional conduct, strive for excellence in education and employment, and commit and support the community, country, and society. The winners of this award will receive $100. This year's winners are an early childhood education student from Bellefonte, Sabrina Corman, and an information technology student from Bald Eagle, Reagan Sisler. Another round of applause for Reagan and Sabrina, please. Our next three awards go together. These are new this year, and they are the Walker Township Senior Awards. We are pleased to present three seniors with $100, which is sponsored by Walker Township. This year's recipients include Caitlin Bechtel, who is a Bellefonte student in our medical science program, Abigail Billett, who is a Bellefonte student in our early childhood education program, and Colton Dietrich, who's an information technology student from Bellefonte. Grab a hold of that. Another round of applause, please, for Caitlin, Abigail, and Colton. Congratulations. Our next award is the Millipore Sigma Award. This award is sponsored by Millipore Sigma in Pleasant Gap. This award is given to a student who demonstrates outstanding leadership, perseverance, and commitment during their time at CPI. The winner of this award will receive $150. This year, the Millipore Sigma Award recipient is a medical science student from Bald Eagle, Haley Watson. A long walk, Haley, sorry. Another round of applause for Haley, please. And I'm going to put this disclaimer out there right now. If I start to go faster, it has everything to do with everything up there. So I'll keep an eye on you and protect you. But if I start to go faster, you'll know why. Our next two awards are the Bellefonte Women's Club Awards. The Bellefonte Women's Club is awarding two $200 scholarships to two deserving students to assist them as they begin their careers or with their post-secondary plans. The winners of this award are two Bald Eagle students, Maya Barton from Early Childhood, and Joe Shawley from Welding.
No. Maya, congratulations.
Shake your hand's orders. You didn't shake them hand.
Congratulations.
I'm going to keep on moving. Congratulations to Maya and Joe. Sorry, you two, but I'm getting nervous here. Our next award is the Women of the Moose Award in the amount of $200. This year's winner is Sabrina Corman, who is an early childhood education student from Bellefonte. Come on up again, Sabrina. Sabrina, you're going to get your steps in here. Congratulations to Sabrina. Mr. Hank Yeagley served on our Joint Operating Committee for 20 years. During his time as our JOC president, his outstanding leadership helped CPI grow into the school it is today. Enrollment has increased, we are recognized as an outstanding career and technical school in Pennsylvania, and we offer associate degree and specialized technology degrees in several program areas thanks to Hank's vision and tenacity to reach goals. The Henry Yeagley Scholarship is presented to a student who has chosen to return to CPI to pursue their post-secondary training. This $250 is given to a deserving student to help assist with the cost of furthering his education at CPI. Tonight's winner has chosen to enroll in the CPI AST CAT Aerial Program. The winner of the Henry Yeagley Scholarship is a diesel repair student from Penns Valley, Dylan Lowe. Congratulations to Dylan, please. Our next three awards are the Arletta Walker Memorial Scholarships. Arletta Walker's life can be summed up by this poem that she loved called Wish You. When your spirit is low, I wish you beauty. When you are troubled, I wish you peace. When you are lonely, I wish you love. When you are sad, I wish you joy. When you are discouraged, I wish you hope. Much like the attitude we call the CPI way, Arletta Walker was a woman who was compassionate towards everyone, loved the underdogs, and recognized those in the background, and was a relentless champion for people finding their way. Each of our three 2022 award recipients will receive $500. Award recipients include, from Collision Repair and Bellefonte, Matthew Meeker. From HVAC and Bellefonte, Quentin Reed. And from Emergency Services from Penns Valley, Elizabeth Spiker. I guess Matt's not waiting for the other two. I do. Matt, you've been watching for a couple minutes now, you know. Start to stop there. Sorry, we have a good time usually, and I like to pick, and I know I probably shouldn't do that tonight, but it's just in me. So congratulations to our three award winners. Sorry, Matt. Next is our Outstanding Construction Trade Student. This award is sponsored by the Associated Builders and Contractors Incorporated. This $500 award is presented to a student enrolled in our construction trade field who exemplifies hard work, ethical standards, and a dedication to their chosen career path. This year, we're giving the award to a carpentry student from Penns Valley, Micah Fedoroff. Let's give Mike another round of applause. Our next two awards are presented by the Touring Group. These awards are to recognize the achievement of a student enrolled in construction trades, as well as a student in the medical science program. This time, I would like to invite Mr. and Mrs. Songer to the stage to say a few things and present the awards.
Good evening. It's really great to be here with so many young people this evening who are ready to enter the next stage of your life, which is going to be hopefully finding a good job here in the Center County area. My wife Sarah and I and our family are strong supporters of vocational education. In our business, which involves owning commercial real estate, office buildings, and doing residential subdivisions, building homes, we use people every day who work in the trades. And we have a lot of respect for these people because we grew up in a family whose parents worked with their hands. Without technically trained people, we wouldn't have a country, as we depend on technically trained people for our everyday needs. And these are people like yourselves who have a bright future in front of you. As the old saying goes, when you need a plumber, you need a plumber. When you need a practical nurse, you need a practical nurse. My favorite founding father, Benjamin Franklin, said, an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. So I encourage you all, never quit learning. Always try to improve yourself in terms of what you know and what you know how to do. It will serve you well. Sarah and I want to wish Michael Fedoroff all the best as he pursues his career in the building construction trades, and Taylor Wetzel as she pursues her nursing career. We want to thank both of you, and maybe someday we'll need your services. Both of you and all of you have a bright future ahead. Thank you.
Can I have Micah and Taylor please come up? Micah's learning. He came back for you. Congratulations to Micah and Taylor. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Songer.
Thank you. We follow the rules. We kept it short.
Very good. Our next two awards are the David B. Garver Memorial Scholarships. The David B. Garver Memorial Scholarship is sponsored by the Bellefonte Elks Lodge. In awarding two $750 scholarships, scholastic achievement, leadership, and financial need are taken into consideration. The recipients of the David Garver Memorial Scholarship is a student from HEO in Penns Valley, Barry Decker, and a medical science student from Bellefonte, Paige Shivery.
Thank you. Well,
got to wait for page break.
Congratulations.
Another round of applause for Paige and Barry. At this time, we will present the Outstanding Cooperative Education Student Award. The 2022 Cooperative Education Student of the Year is an early childhood student from Bellefonte, Maddie Jackson. Maddie will receive a plaque, a Kids Connection staff t-shirt, and a gift card sponsored by Redmond's Kids Connection. I want to put a plug in for Redmond's. They do very well by their employees. Congratulations, Maddie. Our next award is the Excellence in Attendance Award, which is sponsored by the Pleasant Gap Rotary Club. This award is presented to a student who is demonstrating outstanding attendance during his enrollment at CPI. This year's award winner has only missed 2 days of school in 3 years. At CPI, I don't know about the homeschool, but at CPI, he's only missed 2 days of school. The award recipient will receive a plaque and $150. The Excellence in Attendance Award is a student in our Information Technology program and a Bald Eagle student, James Geiser. Congratulations, James. Give him a big round of applause. Seriously, 2 days in 3 years. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay, we're down to our last two special recognition awards. At this time, I would like to invite Ben Martin from First National Bank to the stage to present our Student Excellence Award.
The CPI Student Excellence Award recognizes an individual who has distinguished academic and technical credentials, has made significant contributions to CPI, and has the personal attributes of character and integrity that have earned the respect and admiration of his peers, instructors, and administration. This year's award winner is a member of NTHS. He is a Boy Scout who is working to complete his Eagle Scout Award and is a member of the Logan Fire Company. After high school, he plans to attend Cedarville University to get his Master's of Divinity. The recipient of the Student Excellence Award will receive a $500 award. CPI's Student Excellence Award for 2022 is presented to a student from Bellefonte enrolled in our Emergency Services Program, Andrew McChesney.
Give Andrew another round of applause, please. Congratulations. So at this time, we are going to present our 2022 CPI Outstanding Student of the Year Award. This is a $1,000 check and a plaque, and it's sponsored by Reliance Bank. Motivated, hardworking, honest, compassionate, intelligent, and dedicated are just a few words that describe the 2022 CPI Outstanding Student. This is an individual who leads confidently while remaining down to earth and is assertive yet conscientious of others. In her teacher's words, she is conscientious and wants to do what is right. She is a well-rounded, highly motivated individual who puts 100% into everything, whether it be academics, extracurricular activities, or family. I will miss her smile, energy, and love for learning. She has a natural ability when working in her chosen career path. She has inspired me to be a better person and teacher. While I will miss all of these things about her, perhaps what I will miss the most is her personality, positive energy, warm smile, and love for learning. The 2022 Outstanding CPI Student is a member of the National Technical Honor Society, FCCLA, SkillsUSA, a member of the CPI Local Advisory Committee, a student ambassador, a cooperative education student, and has volunteered at many of our special events over the past several years. She was accepted to Penn State University, where she will major in early childhood education and elementary education. The CPI Outstanding Student Award winner will receive $1,000, as I previously mentioned, and it's sponsored by Reliance Bank. CPI's Outstanding Student for the 21-22 school year is a student in early childhood education program and Miss BEA, Maya Barton. Big round of applause, everyone, for Maya, 2022's Outstanding CPI Student. Maya, stop. Wave to the crowd with your Miss BEA. Wave. Okay, thank you. Congratulations to all of our award winners. At this time, I'm going to ask Mrs. Weaver and Dr. Macon, they're already here, to join me, and we're going to present our seniors with their program certificates and awards. How we do this, we'll do one program at a time, and there are special awards that go with each program. Our first program to the stage this evening is our Advertising and Commercial Arts program. Mr. Donald Crane Jr. is the instructor. Alexander C. Gilbert. Emma R. Shawley. So for Ad Arts, we have two awards to give. The first one is a $100 award sponsored by Advertising and Commercial Arts Occupational Advisory Committee, and that is presented to Emma Shawley. You'll get that later. And then the 2022 Outstanding Advertising Arts Program Area student is Alexander Gilbert. Congratulations to our 2022 Advertising and Commercial Arts graduates. Thank you. Our next program to the stage is Automotive Science Technology. Mr. Michael Seip is the instructor. Dylan R. Beerley. Stop, paramedic. We need a paramedic. Mr. Crane, you can go ahead. Erica? Our school nurse is on the way as well. Everybody just remain seated. JC, did you get candy? Did somebody get candy? Favorite lollipops? Go that way, just in case. J. JC just passed them up. Okay, we're going to go ahead and get back to our programs. Our next program is Automotive Science Technology. Mr. Michael Seip is our instructor. Dylan R. Beerley, Brett M. Delaney, Michael W. Hill, Isaiah A. Hodge, Raymond J. Knepp, Madison C. McCaslin, Isaac J. Packer, Christopher L. Robinson, Brody A. Schreckengast, Colin J. Winnett, For the Automotive Technology Program, we have four awards to give. I'll just ask each of them to step forward if they get an award, and again, they'll pick them up over at the ticket booth later. The Jan Maurer Memorial Award for $50 is presented to Isaiah Hodge. Isaiah, step forward. Thank you, Isaiah. A $100 Instructors Award is presented to Colin Winnett. Colin, please step forward. A $100 Instructors Award is presented to Christopher Robinson. And I'll ask Mr. Seip to come over and get his outstanding student plaque. Oh, do you already have it? Sorry, I'm behind. The 2022 Outstanding Program Area Student for Automotive Technology is Christopher Robinson. Congratulations to our Automotive Technology Class of 2022. Our next program is Carpentry and Building Construction Technology. Mr. Martin Crane is the instructor. Mr. Crane is not able to be with us this evening. Micah G. Federoff, Gavin M. Kuhn, Dawson T. Lee, and Justin L. Smith. We have three awards to give in carpentry this evening. The first one is the J. Alvin Hobbaker Memorial Award from the Builders Association of Central PA, and that is $100, and that goes to Dawson Lee. Dawson, step forward. Our second one is the Colonel Donald E. Antis Memorial Award from the Builders Association of Central PA, and that is also $100, and that goes to Justin Smith. And our 2022 Outstanding Program Area Student from Carpentry is Gavin Kuhn. Now, Gavin, I'm going to have you lead everybody off the stage there since Mr. Crane's not here. Congratulations to our Class of 2022 Carpentry students. Our next program is Collision Repair Technology. Our instructor is Mr. Brian Hummel, Matthew J. Meeker, Logan T. Snyder, and Timothy A. Wingert. This evening, we have four awards to present in collision repair. The first one is Rechargeable Hands Free Neck Light, and it's furnished by Capital Auto Refinishing Supplies, and that goes to Logan Snyder. Our second award is an Orbital Sander from Capital Automotive Refinishing, and that goes to Matthew Meeker. We also have a 61-piece mechanics tool set from Capital Automotive Refinishing, and that's going to Timothy Wingert. And our 2022 Outstanding Collision Repair student is Matthew Meeker. Congratulations to our Class of 2022 Collision Repair. Our next program is Cosmetology. Our instructor is Mrs. Alicia Kitchen, Alexis S. Bilby, Rosanna J. Castiglia, Rachel M. Drabelbus, Tenley M. Gates, Riley T. Hart, Dylan E. Hartley, J.C. L. Masden, Carly J. Miller, Abby E. Palmer, Reagan A. Ryder, Ariel E. Rogers, Raya D. Spangler, Kara M. Steffi, Haley M. Stroud, Olivia N. Taylor, and Rachel J. White. For cosmetology this evening, we have three awards. The first one is a $50 award donated by YouTube Beauty and Wellness, and that is presented to Alexis Bilby. The second one is a $100 award donated by YouTube Beauty and Wellness, and that is presented to Abby Palmer. And our 2022 Outstanding Program Area Student in Cosmetology is none other than our Lollipop Girl, J.C. Masden. J.C., step forward. You can't hide there. Congratulations to our 2022 cosmetology class. Thank you, ladies. Our next program is Culinary Arts, Food and Beverage Management, and our instructor is Chef Timothy Beckenbaugh. Aiden L. Andrews, Daniel S. Gray, Tiffany D. Grebe, Riley A. Kellerman, Raymond E. Walker, and Joshua L. Wright. We have three awards to present for Culinary Arts. The first one is a $50 award sponsored by the Pleasant Gap Rotary Club, and that is presented to Daniel Gray. Daniel, step forward. The second item is a professional knife set with a case from Curtsy Company, and that goes to Riley Kellerman. And our 2022 Outstanding Culinary Arts Program student is Riley Kellerman. Congratulations, Culinary Arts Class of 2022. Our next program is Dental Assisting. Mrs. Mindy Tobias is the instructor. Ms. Heidi Wagner is the assistant instructor. Sierra L. Biggins, Kaylee E. Cadman, Katrina Garasenko, Melina Gusova, Majene M. Johnson, Lexis N. Shaver, and Marissa L. Slagan. This evening in dental, we have three awards to present. The first one is a $200 award from the Bellefonte Dental and Bellefonte Dentistry, and that goes to Katrina Garasenko. Our second one is a $250 award presented by Dentistry by April Detar and Pediatric Dental Care, and that goes to Kaylee Cadman. And our 2022 Outstanding Dental Assisting Student is Kaylee Cadman. Congratulations to the Dental Assisting Class of 2022. Our next program area is Diesel Equipment Maintenance and Repair Technology. Mr. John Fike III is the instructor. Caleb R. Bennett, Noah C. Fedoroff, Braden M. Greenaway, Ryan P. Homan, Dylan A. Lowe, Matthew L. Lucas, Dominic M. McCaslin, Naaman L. Watkins, and Gage M. Whitehill. We have 11 awards to give out. The first one is the Michael D. Byrd Memorial Award in the amount of $50, and that is presented to Caleb Bennett. Caleb, step forward. Next, we have the Robert A. Byrd Memorial Award in the amount of $50, and that goes to Gage Whitehill. NAPA has been nice enough to give us several $50 gift cards, Napa State College. They are presented to Matthew Lucas, Dominic McCaslin. Step forward, gentlemen. Matthew Lucas and Dominic McCaslin. Next, we have several $100 Mac Tool gift cards to present, and that was donated by Glenn O. Hawbaker, Noah Fedoroff, Caleb Bennett, Braden Greenaway, Ryan Homan, and Dylan Lowe. The next one is a $100 Cornwell Tools gift certificate, and that goes to Gage Whitehill. And our diesel equipment repair student for 2022, outstanding student, Caleb Bennett. Congratulations, diesel repair class of 2022. Our next program area is early childhood education. Mrs. Erin Gearhart is the instructor. Maya L. Barton, Abigail L. Billett, Emma N. Bird, Sabrina M. Corman, Lexis R. Evans, Kylie R. Hockenberry, Madison E. Jackson, Samantha M. Miller, Mackenzie G. Suter, and Chastity L. Woods. Mrs. Gearhart wanted to be as tall as her students. We have four awards to give out this evening for early childhood. The first one is a $250 award sponsored by Redmond's Kid Connection, and that is presented to Maya Barton. We have a second $250 award sponsored by Redmond's Kids Connection, and that goes to Maddie Jackson. A $50 gift card sponsored by Your First Page Learning is presented to Emma Bird. And our 2022 Outstanding Early Childhood Student is Maya Barton. There's an inside joke with that stool, but we won't go into it now. Right, Maya?
No.
Okay. Congratulations to our 2022 Early Childhood Education class. Our next program area is emergency services. Our instructor is Mrs. Shanine Leiter. Mackenzie J.R. Bechtel, Jalen P. Hahn, Anna R. Hegedus, Benjamin D. Keys, Samantha L. Kramer, Samantha L. Lamatier, Andrew M. McChesney, Carter J. Murray, Michaela A. Ripka, Mackenzie E. Snyder, Elizabeth M. Spiker, and Ronnie E. Tickner. For emergency services this evening, there are three awards. The first one is a $100 award sponsored by the Pleasant Gap Rotary Club, and that is presented to Michaela Ripka. The Undine Fire Company each year is gracious enough through the Richard Heverly Memorial Award to present $500 to an emergency services student, and that goes to Andrew McChesney. And our 2022 Outstanding Emergency Services student is Andrew McChesney. Congratulations to our Emergency Services Class of 2022. Our next program area is heating, ventilation, and air conditioning and refrigeration, and our instructor is Mr. Jeff McArdle. Mason R. Heffron, Thomas J. Corman, Quentin D. Reed, and Gavin D. Welch. We have two awards to present. The first is $100 from the Clyde W. Comfer Memorial Award, and that is presented to Quentin Reed. And our 2022 Outstanding HVAC student is Thomas Corman. Congratulations, HVAC Class of 2022. Our next program area is Heavy Equipment Operations Technology. Our instructor is Mr. Chris Skelly II, and assistant instructor, Mrs. Don Doherty. Riley M. Bringart, Chandler L. Burns, Dustin E. Burns, Braden M. Comley, Luke H. Comfer, Barry D. Decker, Alan M. Dixon, Corbin M. G. Edmonds, Matthew A. Gillette, Caleb D. Homan, Jacob B. Hummel, Colby W. Lohr, Nathaniel J. Long, Hunter A. McCool, Caleb A. Rossman, and Alex T. Shuey. We have 7 awards to give out in heavy equipment. The first is a $50 Memorial Award, which is the Ronald J. Gummo Senior Memorial Award, and that is presented to Chandler Burns. We have a second Ronald J. Gummo Senior Memorial Award for $50 that's presented to a student entering the military. This young man is going into the Army National Guard, and that is presented to Braden Comley. The Methetta Blair Memorial Award for $500 is presented to Corbin Edmonds. The Dylan Thomas Swank Scholarship for $500 is presented to Colby Lohr. The Tyler Rogers Memorial Scholarship for $500 is presented to Alex Shuey. At this time, I would like to call Mr. Josh Hall to the stage to present the next award.
Good evening. My name is Josh Hall. I am here on behalf of Dan Hallbaker and his family's company, Glenn O. Hallbaker Incorporated. I will be presenting the Glenn O. Hallbaker Award that is presented annually to CPI's Outstanding Heavy Equipment Operator. Before doing so, I'd like to share some Hallbaker family history with you. The Hallbaker family moved to Center County in 1945 from a farm in Franklin County following World War II. Armed with nothing more than Glenn O's farm background and Navy experience, and fortunately Thelma's high school education, they worked together from scratch to build a new life. After approximately 6 years of long hours and hard work, Dan's father and mother had built equity in their ownership of a home and a car. That equity was enough to support a loan that enabled the Glenn O. Hallbaker Company to begin in 1952, with the purchase of various pieces of excavation equipment from Glenn O.'s brother, J. Alvin Hallbaker, who is a community home builder. This background is given to you to help you to perhaps appreciate a starting point that involved the entire Hallbaker family. All of the 4 siblings had a hand in moving the enterprise forward. They all started their business experience very early in life. This award is dedicated to Glenn O. and Thelma in recognition of them acting as Hallbaker's family's CPI. Their start in 1952 gave rise to the success that has supported many families within our community and beyond. GOH is now in its 4th generation, and the ownership has stayed in the Hallbaker name. We believe CPI offers paths to careers that are important to placing young people on their own without onerous student debt or mortgages. This is a place where aspirations can become reality and where dedication to a trade or skill with drive and determination can lead to becoming an entrepreneur and to building an enterprise. The Hallbaker family participation in CPI is to help forward opportunities for students and adult students in reaching careers into an unpredictable and opportunistic world of possibilities. We'd like to personally thank Dr. Mankin and his entire supporting staff for all that they do to ensure the current and future success of CPI. This year's Glenn O. Hallbaker Memorial Award is presented to Barry Decker. Congratulations.
I felt a drop. And our last award is the Heavy Equipment Outstanding Student, and that is Barry Decker. Congratulations, Heavy Equipment Class of 2022. Our next program area is Horticulture and Landscape. Mr. Joe Luther is our instructor. Harley G. Benner, Cheyenne M. Butts, Mackenzie L. Hockenberry, Jordan M. Kleinfelder. We have 5 awards to give. The first one is an Outstanding FFA Student Award, and that's sponsored by Center County FFA for $200, and that goes to Harley Benner. The next one is the James F. Luther Award for $200, and that goes to Jordan Kleinfelder. The next two, the Wilda H. Farrell Stanford Memorial Award for $200. One is to Harley Benner, and the other goes to Mackenzie Hockenberry. And her 2022 Outstanding Program Area Award goes to Harley Benner. Congratulations to the Horticulture and Landscaping Class of 2022. Our next program area is Information Technology and Cisco. Our instructor is Mr. Alan Caparel. Matthew H. Alt, Logan W. Blair, Kyle J. Blesch, Colton J. Dietrich, Preston M. Gano, James A. Geiser, John W. Holzerman, Austin T. Moore, Ashton B. Phillips, Reagan S. Sisler, Caden L. Thomas, Garrett A. Woods, and Max E. Yetzko. Several awards to give out. There are $250 awards in an iFixit kit. They go to Colton Dietrich and Max Yetzko. Next is an Excellence in Technology Award sponsored by Black Hoof Technology. It's $200 in iFixit kit, and that goes to Ashton Phillips. A Teacher Appreciation Award donated by Alan Caparel for $100 is presented to Kyle Blesch. And the 2022 Outstanding Program Area Student for Information Technology is Ashton Phillips. Congratulations to the 2022 Information Technology class. I'm trying, everybody. It's almost over. Our next program is Medical Science Technology. Dr. Chris Hartley is our instructor. Kayla M. Akins, Caitlin L. Bechtel, Desiree E. Cox, Alexis D. Fisher, Olivia G. Horner, Tiana A. Kitchen, Justine E. Leiter, Cameron A. Martin, Aaliyah G. Armon, Caitlin M. Park, Krislin G. Ronk, Paige A. Shivery, Lindsay M. Smiles, Adelia E. Sukup-Gitt, Tylese I. Washington, Haley F. Watson, Taylor S. Wetzel, and Rayleigh A. Ziegler. And we have two awards to give out this evening. The first one is the Lewis E. Etter Memorial Award for $100, donated by the Etter Law Firm, and that goes to Caitlin Bechtel. And our outstanding medical science technology outstanding medical science technology student, who is also going to nationals in skills for the second year in a row, I like to say that, is Paige Shivery. Congratulations to our class of 2022 medical science students. You're all concerned about the rain, and I'm concerned about the ink on my page. Almost. Yeah, but there's still ink smears here. Our next program area is Precision Machine Technology. Our instructor is Mr. Michael Klein. Quinton S. Bennett, Jaden A. King, and Nolan M. Stover. Since it stopped raining, the first award of two that we're going to give out are the Coy Lutz Memorial Scholarships, and they're both for $500. One goes to a precision machine student and one goes to a welding student. I would like to take a minute, since it stopped a little bit, and read what Coy's parents sent. On May 28, 2016, Coy passed away at the young age of 19. Coy was our son, he was a brother, and he was a good friend to many. When Coy was little, he begged his dad to let him rodeo. Coy's dad, Doug, rode bareback horses and later became a bullfighter. As parents, we decided that at 6 or 7 years old, he was too young for this sport. Coy never let go of his dream, and he continued to try to change our minds until he was 14. When he was finally allowed to start practicing on a bucking machine, he was all in. A short time later, he had the opportunity to do the same thing at the Pennsylvania Farm Show. His mom remembers that day very well. As they were driving to the farm show, she said to him, "You know, Cody, nobody's going to think any less of you if you don't ride today. This is your decision." As the new kid, no one talked to him or offered him any help, but he made it a point to talk to everyone. It was not until after he rode that the other kids started to talk to him. Coy never forgot what it felt like to be the kid no one would talk to because he made a point to talk to everyone. He had the ability to make each person feel as if they were his best friend. He stood up for what he believed in and what he knew was right. He always had a smile on his face, and he didn't have a mean bone in his body. He worked hard and he played harder. This fund was created to help young people chase their dreams with the hope that someday they would pay it forward. Coy graduated in 2015 from Bald Eagle and completed his technical education as part of our CPI Precision Machine program. The winner of the Coy Lutz Memorial Scholarship in Precision Machine for $500 is Nolan Stover. Step forward, Nolan. Step forward. And our CPI 2022 Outstanding Precision Machine Technology student is Nolan Stover. Congratulations to our 2022 Precision Machine Technology students. Our last program is Welding and Metal Fabrication Technology. Mr. Edward Finney Frock is the instructor. Ty N. Cronin, Hunter R. Lucas, Trevor B. Poorman, Joseph R. Schrankel, Joseph D. Shawley, Noah W. Unkefer. We have five awards to give. The first one is a grinder and supplies sponsored by Roberts Oxygen, and that goes to Joe Shawley. The second one is the Anthony Duran Memorial Award for $300, and that goes to Joe Schrankel. The second Coy Lutz Memorial Scholarship for $500 in welding is presented to Joe Shawley. The Jason Weaver Memorial Award for $1,000 is presented to Ty Cronin. And our Welding and Metal Fabrication Outstanding Student for 2022 is Joseph Shawley. Congratulations to our welding class of 2022. Okay, I'm down to a page and a quarter, and then it's Dr. Macon's turn. The amount of work that goes into making this event a special occasion is enormous. I want to thank the Penns Valley Administration and Board of Directors for providing this wonderful facility for us to use this evening. Thank you to Dr. Brian Griffith, the Penns Valley Superintendent and our Superintendent of Record, Mr. Bob Miller, Director of Facilities at PV, and the Penns Valley Maintenance and Custodial staff for the extra time and effort you've put into making this ceremony possible for us. Not only do you have to prepare for your own graduation, but you helped us get everything ready and for this wonderful evening. Let's give them a round of applause to say thank you. Next, I want to thank Mrs. Teresa Brickley, our Executive Secretary at CPI. She makes this evening happen. She spends many evenings and weekends leading up to this event to get everything ready, giving up usually her Memorial Day weekend even. And she makes sure we have everything that we need. I want to thank our office staff for their help this evening. They're always willing to help in any way that they can and always add the finishing touches to everything that we do. Finally, I want to thank Mr. Rick Kara, our Director of Facilities at CPI, and his staff for working with the Penns Valley custodians to get everything ready for tonight. Let's give this group a round of applause. CPI instructors, instructional staff, all please stand up. Stand up. I think the students follow directions better sometimes than the adults. I would like to thank the CPI instructors and staff for the amazing job that they do every day. Like the past several years, this has been full of unexpected challenges and changes. However, the CPI staff is amazing at focusing on the successes and positive outcomes that we experience each day. They have been so resilient in dealing with everything that has come our way. I'm very thankful for all of you. They are the key component in the success of our students and our institution. Please give them a round of applause, students. And last but not least, okay, you can sit down now. Thanks to the parents and guardians for the opportunity to provide career and technical education to your son and daughter. This is an amazing group of young men and women who have demonstrated perseverance, professionalism, and compassion. I appreciate everything that you've instilled in them at home to make such wonderful young adults out of them. Seniors and teachers, please give your parents and guardians a round of applause. I want to end with three quotes from Dr. Seuss, not knowing that Mrs. Weaver was going to use Dr. Seuss, but it works out. On the conclusion of your high school experience, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. On being passionate about all you do, unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing is going to get better, it's not. On following your dreams, you have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. Your journey is just getting started. It has been my pleasure to be a part of your educational journey. You have been one of the most amazing classes we've had in 14 years. Thank you. I wish you the best of luck in everything that you do. Congratulations to the CPI class of 2022. At this time, I would like to invite Dr. Macon to the podium for his closing remarks, and he promised us he'd keep it under 30 minutes.
There were a lot of thank yous there from Mrs. Volders, with one exception. So Mrs. Volders, where'd she go? Come on up here. We owe Mrs. Volders a huge thank you, and in particular, I'm talking to the graduates, for all that she's done the years that you've been at CPI. I can't tell you what a pleasure it is for me to work with her. So please join me in thanking Mary Ann Volders. My background is ag, and I've always felt a little bit of rain doesn't hurt anybody. But I am going to shorten up my remarks to 30 minutes or so if no one has any objections. Is that okay, or would you rather get out of here? Okay. Tonight is a night of celebration and commendation, a milestone event in the lives of the CPI class of 2022, and your families. To the class of 2022, I offer my congratulations on your successes at CPI and your sending schools. You, your families, friends, and all those who have supported you can be very proud. To the parents and families of our graduates, thank you for entrusting your students to us. We have appreciated the opportunity and the privilege of having them at CPI. Graduates, as you leave CPI, I encourage you, stay positive and keep hope and optimism alive in these challenging times. You can, and I believe that you will, make a positive difference. You are the future, and I am confident you will usher in tomorrow with resounding success. Now it is your opportunity to be a CPI champion. Class of 2022, please accept my very best wishes for your personal happiness and professional success. At this time, I will ask our graduates to rise and face our guests. Families and friends, it is my pleasure to present to you the CPI class of 2022.